Hey, shalom everyone. This is Chris Shoemaker, also known as Yehuda ben Shomer, and welcome to the Daily Drosh. Today's Daily Drosh is taken from Deuteronomy chapter 22, and I'm going to be reading from the World English Bible. And it begins, "You shall not see your brother's ox or his sheep go astray, and hide yourself from them. You shall surely bring them again to your brother. If your brother isn't near you, or you do not know him, then you shall bring it home to your house, and it shall be with you until your brother comes looking for it, and you shall restore it to him. So you shall do with his donkey, so shall you do with his garment, so shall you do with every lost thing of your brother's, which he has lost and you have found. You may not hide yourself." So this is a Torah biblical principle, a godly divine principle about lost and found, about finding something somebody has lost and restoring it unto them, taking it unto yourself and taking care of it as if it was your own until whoever lost it comes looking for it, and you give it back to them. That we cannot opt out when we see something laying on the ground saying, "Oh, well, it's not my problem," or, "Oh, that doesn't pertain to me because it's not mine," or, "Oh, too bad, too sad for that guy." We're obligated to take it and try to find whose it is and restore it to them, or keep it until the person comes looking for it. But we live in a day and age where we've lost the concept. It's almost a foreign concept, lost and found. It's more of a principle of finders keepers, losers weepers. You know, you lost it, you negated your rights to it. I found it, therefore it's mine. And that's the westernized principle of finding something that's not yours. There is no concept of lost and found anymore. There used to be lost and found bins in just about every public establishment. That's not the case anymore. People just either throw it away or keep it for themselves. They don't even attempt to find whose it is. They don't care. It's not their problem. But the Torah obligates us that if we find something that is lost, that we must try to find the owner of that item, or that we keep it until that person comes looking for it themselves. Also, it is interesting, as opposed to Western thought, in Hebraic thought, we cannot possess anything. We cannot have anything. There is not, yes, there is, you know, the Bible translates certain things from the Hebrew as to have, but as we understand having something or ownership of something, it's a foreign concept in the Hebrew language. You cannot have anything in the Hebrew language. At best, in English, we would say, he has a car. In the literal Hebrew, it would be, to him is a car. In English, he has a house, or it's his house. In the Hebrew, to him, there is a house. So in other words, everything that we think we have and we think we possess, we don't really have, we don't really possess. We are just in temporary ownership, temporary custody, temporary stewardship of everything that is in our life. And in Hebrew, that reminds us that everything that we have comes from God. It's by his permission, his will, his gift that we have anything. We cannot truly own or keep or possess or have anything. And the Hebrew teaches us to just hold on to things loosely because things come and go. But the things that we can truly have, that are truly ours, that is truly ownership given to us that can't be taken away, is our integrity, our morals, the Torah, our personal salvation, our relationship, our personal relationship with God, our relationship with others, our love. These things cannot be our belief, our standards. They can't be taken away from us. But everything physical that represents sometimes those very spiritual and mental things can be taken away. So we can't truly possess or have anything in this life. So this Torah passage is teaching us not to steal, but to take care of others' possessions as if they were our own in hopes that they'll come and find it, or that we can find the owner. So we need to get back to that principle because we've lost that principle. You know, if somebody sees a cell phone, they take it. They don't try to find whose it is. You know, they take it, they erase it, and they resell it or use it themselves. Finders keepers, losers weepers. Finders keepers, losers suck. You know, no, the Bible, the Torah, God clearly wants us to have a lost and found concept and principle, that if we find something, that we try to find who the owner is, or that if we can't find the owner, that we keep it and take care of it as if it was our own until the person comes looking for it and we're to restore it to them. We don't have any rights or ownership to it just because we took care of it and, you know, they've lost their right to keep it. That's not the way it goes. Anyways, thanks so much for listening. Go out there and have a great day. Shalom and Shavuot Tov. abrahamsdescendants.com, getting back to the first century in a 21st century way. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to press the like button as well as the subscribe button if you haven't done so already, and the notification bell that'll let you know every time I make a new video. And don't forget to share this with a friend. Also, visit our website at abrahamsdescendants.com. Thanks. Shalom. Thanks for watching. Stay connected by subscribing to our other social media accounts and visiting our website at abrahamsdescendants.com.